Hi people, it's me, Anya. My pronouns are she, her, and welcome back to my channel for a new recent reads video. Before we get into these books, please remember to donate to Palestine. So, yeah. The first book on this list is called Orphans of the Tide. This book is absolutely so good. I ended up rating it 4 stars because I really enjoyed it. This book is a middle grade fantasy, and it follows Ellie, who's a young inventor, which I think is so cool, and it added such an interesting element to the story. Her inventions and her brilliance and her intelligence were so awesome. Anyway, her story starts off when a mysterious boy washes in from the shore, and everybody thinks that he's one of the gods who drowned the world, so they really don't like him, but she doesn't believe that. So yeah, this book is so good. Like I mentioned before, I ended up rating it 4 stars because I really enjoyed it. First of all, like I mentioned, Ellie is such a wonderful, lovely, well-developed character, and her friend group is so lovely and well-developed as well. Like, the boy is such a wonderful, well-developed character. Ellie's best friend is such a wonderful, well-developed character as well, and I love the dynamic between all three of them. The plot was so intriguing. The world building is so cool. This book was so good, and it kept me at the edge of my seat. It was absolutely so awesome. And I'm so excited to read the sequel. I know the sequel's out already because I think it came out in March. But anyway, I'm so excited to read it because I'm so excited to dive back into this adventure with Ellie. Because like I said, she is such a wonderful character. And I'm so excited to read from her point of view again. So with that said, I would highly, highly recommend this book because it's absolutely so great. The next book on this list is called Almost Flying. This book is absolutely so good as well. I also ended up rating it 4 stars, so we love to see it. This book follows a young sapphic girl when her week-long amusement park road trip turns into a true roller coaster of emotions when she realizes that she likes her new friend as more than just a friend. This book is so good. It was so wholesome and so sweet and so well done, and I'm so emotionally connected to the main character because I was so emotionally invested in her. I really, really liked this book. It was so well done. The sapphic representation and the cute sapphic romance that resulted was so awesome because it was so sweet. It was so sweet and it was so wholesome and it was just so good. This book is absolutely so good, and I really, really enjoyed it because it was absolutely so soft and so happy, and it was so well done. And like I said, the main character is such a wonderful, well-developed, lovely main character. And I loved that she had such a wonderful, strong family unit that was so supportive. We loved to see it. And her love interest was such a wonderful, lovely character as well. So overall, need I say the word wholesome and sweet again? This book is literally so good. And with that, I would highly, highly recommend it. Because like I said, I gave it 4 stars. The next book on this list is called We Can't Keep Meeting Like This by Rachel Lynn Solomon. This book is a YA contemporary, and it follows Quinn, who's disillusioned with love as she goes through a summer of weddings because her family is a wedding planner organization, and how she learns to be more honest with herself. I don't know if that made any sense at all, but essentially, I did really, really enjoy this book. I had pretty high expectations because I've read all of Rachel's previous young adult books before, so I kind of knew what I was getting into. For example, I knew that Rachel's writing was going to be absolutely so awesome and so superb and so descriptive and so well done. So that was the first thing that I really enjoyed. Second of all, I really enjoyed Quinn's character arc. It was so well done and so lovely. Third of all, I really enjoyed the Jewish representation and the mental health representation. We love to see it. But, however, with all of that said, I felt like the romance in this book was kind of rushed and it happened too fast. And maybe that was the point, but that does not negate the fact that I didn't ship the main couple, but I do understand why people do ship them. You know what I mean? I just felt like the romantic development happened and started a little bit too fast. So overall, this book in particular is my least favorite of Rachel's young adult books, But I'm still looking forward to her next book, which comes out next year, and I think it's called like See You Tonight or something like that. I'm not completely sure. Maybe it's called See You Yesterday. Actually, I don't really know. But anyway, I'm so excited for it, and I believe it comes out next year. So yeah. With that said, I rated this book 4 stars because I did really enjoy it. But unfortunately, out of all of Rachel's young adult books, this one is my least favorite. But that doesn't mean that I didn't really enjoy it, because I did really enjoy it, because like I said, I gave it 4 stars. Anyway, there's that. The next book on this list is called All or Hidden Gifts. This book is so good. It's a YA urban paranormal fantasy, and it's absolutely so awesome, and I ended up rating it 4 stars. It follows a young girl named Maeve, whose accurate tailored readings have kind of made her the talk of the school, until her latest one causes her former best friend to disappear, or so she thinks. This book is so good. First of all, the plot was so intriguing, and it was so well done. Second of all, the world building was so immersive, and it was so intriguing, and I just really fell in love with it. Third of all, Maeve as a character is such a wonderful, lovely, well-developed character, and her romance and her friendships were so well developed. I've heard a few people say that the main character of this book is sapphic, and I just want to clarify that she isn't. There are many queer characters in this book because, for example, her love interest is gender fluid, but Maeve as a person is straight, in case you were wondering. But anyway, I just wanted to clarify that because I heard some people saying that she was sapphic, so she isn't. Anyway, that did not take away from my enjoyment of the book. This book was so good. It was so awesome, and it was so well done, and honestly, it's really underrated. So with that, I would highly, highly recommend it because it was so good. It kind of reminded me of When We Were Magic, but like so much better. You know what I mean? So anyway, with that, I would highly, highly recommend it. The next book on this list is called I'll Be Home for Christmas. If you didn't know, this is the I Wish You All the Best Christmas novella. So it's set after the events of I Wish You All the Best, and it stars, obviously, the main couple from I Wish You All the Best. This book was quite good. I ended up rating it 3.5 stars because honestly, since it's a novella, there's not much to unpack with it since it's only 60 pages long. However, with that said, I felt like this story felt very authentic, and it truly didn't feel like the author only wrote this story to please their fans. You know what I mean? Like, it felt genuine and it felt real, and I really liked reading this short story about these characters and about their romantic relationship because it was so cute, it was so sweet, and it was so wholesome, and it was so well done. It really felt like I was reading about the characters from I Wish You All the Best again, instead of like characters that I wasn't caring about anymore. You know what I mean? I don't know if that makes any sense at all, but essentially, I rated this book 3.5 stars because it was good and it was solid and it was sweet and it was wholesome. But since this book is a novella and since it wasn't very long, there wasn't much to unpack with it, which is why I cannot rate it any higher than that. So yeah, there's that. The next book on this list is called 1500 Miles from the Sun. This book is a YA contemporary, and there are a couple trigger warnings on this book, but there are 2 main ones for homophobia and an abusive single parent. So just keep that in mind. And also, the trigger warnings all said right before the story starts. So don't worry, when you read this book, you will be warned by everything that happens before you read it. So yeah. Anyway, this book is a YA contemporary, like I mentioned before, and it follows a boy who accidentally propels himself into the life that he's always wanted after he accidentally comes out on Twitter while being drunk. This book was so good. I really enjoyed it. I ended up rating it 4 stars because, first of all, the story felt so soft and it was so sweet and it was so wholesome. It kind of reminded me in that aspect of Meet Cute Diary because it was so cute and it was so wholesome. And I really enjoyed the main character because I think that he has such a great, supportive, support system aside from his father, of course. So that was solid. But my main critique over this story was the romance. I didn't love the romance. I understand why people ship them and why the romance was really cute and really fluffy, but I felt like they had little to no development in the very beginning, so I kind of feel like their romance happened too fast. I tweeted today that the romantic development of the main romance in this book kind of reminded me of the romantic development of Seb and Carlos from High School Musical, the musical, the series, in the sense that their development from just friends to more than friends felt very, very fast and had little to no build-up. So in that sense, I don't really ship them in this book. I definitely ship Seblos from High School Musical, the musical, the series. They're all so cute. But anyway, that's not the point. The point is that in this book, the romantic development just felt a little bit too fast to me. But that's the only thing that I didn't really like about this book. Aside from that, this book was really sweet, and it was really well done, and it was really wholesome, and I can definitely tell why this book means so much to people, because it is really, really good, and like I said, I ended up rating it 4 stars, so with that, I would highly, highly recommend it. So, in conclusion, I rated all of these books 4 stars, except for I'll Be Home for Christmas, so by default, that one is the worst of the bunch, but my favorite of the bunch is definitely Almost Flying. So yeah, I do highly recommend all of these books because they were all really, really good. So yeah, anyway, if you enjoy this video, please don't hesitate to give it a big thumbs up. Comment down below the hippo emoji if you made it all the way to the end of the video. Thanks for watching, donate to Palestine, subscribe if you're new, and I'll see you in my next video. Bye.